research I have done on corporations convinces me that many successful businesses have achieved their growth and their success because they have had a clear and compelling vision as to what success will look like. Now, as an Irishman, it might not surprise you to know that I'm a keen imbiber of a very famous black drink. There are few things in life that give me greater pleasure than going to my local establishment, ordering my favourite drink, waiting patiently for that drink to be poured, and then, before I take my first satisfying sip, I ponder. And as music and chatter fills the background, I ponder why this drink has become so world famous. And by the way, I'm talking about Starbucks coffee here. The reason why Starbucks coffee has become such an amazing brand is because of the clear and compelling vision of the driving force behind Starbucks, Howard Schultz. In 1987, when Howard Schultz came to Chicago to open the first Starbucks unit outside of the Seattle area, he was walking the streets of Chicago with a colleague of his, and he said to that colleague, "In 5 years' time, everyone on this street would be walking around with a Starbucks cup in their hand." But Howard Schultz had a clear and compelling vision. He could see, he could visualize, he could imagine what success would look like. And it was that clear visualization that has energized him to build Starbucks to be the amazing brand that it is today. The question for you is, in your business, do you have a clear and compelling vision as to what success will look like? People often say to me, "Conor, do you have a clear and compelling vision?" And actually, as a speaker and storyteller, I do have a clear and compelling vision. And my clear and compelling vision is that I want to be mentioned in the same sentence as people like good to great author Jim Collins and people like Zig Ziglar. And people say, "Hey, he's pompous, isn't he?" But the actual sentence I want to be mentioned in is, "If you cannot get Conor Cunneen, well, Ziegler or Collins will have to do."
Conor Cunneen is an Irishman, happily exiled in Chicago, where he says the Guinness is drinkable. The natives are friendly, and the hogs are numerous.
"I'm coming, Tim, I'm coming." "Good morning! Good morning! How are we doing, hogs? Dangerous, 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 whoops. How are we doing?
Keep your head and eyes up.
I'm at a riding instructor's conference. Am I? Help! Help! Are we ready, Tim?"
"I'm sure you're in the right place."
"Well, this is an instructor's conference, isn't it?"
"It is."
"Yeah. And why? What's the problem? I was told to come to an instructor's conference."
"Just you're on a bicycle."
"It. Why?"
"This is about motorcycles."
"I've got my contract here. My contract says, oh, sweet holy bacon and cabbage. It's Harley-Davidson. I tell you what happened. My uncle in Ireland, Harry O'Davidson, he has got a bicycle shop in Ireland. Really big one. And a big sign over the bicycle shop which reads, 'Born to Bicycle.' That's what I thought was happening here. So we got, this is very embarrassing. I've cashed the check."
"Oh. Now Jeanette's in trouble."
"I'll tell you what you do. If you continue with the introduction, I'll just sort myself out and I'll wing it after that and we'll pretend none of this ever happened. That might be the best way.
We'll send you back to your van down by the river."
"Don't go away."
"All right. Well, to give you a little bit more information about Conor, he's the former VP of Marketing for Unilever. winner of Chicago's Humorous Speaker of the Year, for, would you believe, a speech on customer service in San Quentin Jail. Wow. To give an example of his sense of humor, this man had surgery for prostate cancer last year. He entered the hospital with a newly purchased pair of pajamas bearing the Monty Python legend, "It's just a flesh wound." So, I think he's getting some composure back there. Please welcome Conor Cunneen, who will tell us how the gift of gab can give you that top of the morning feeling.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Rock and roll. Now, because of my Irish background and heritage, you might be expecting a greeting like top of the morning or 100,000 welcomes. But you know, if you were back in Ireland today at an event like this, because Ireland now is such a vibrant, cosmopolitan and multicultural society, it's quite likely that rather than hearing a greeting like top of the morning, that your speaker will actually say something to you like, "Hey, what's up?" So what's up, hogs? Since I come to the States, I've heard the greeting top of the morning more often than I ever heard it in Ireland. But I love people actually saying it to me now. So what I would like to do is, I would like to throw top of the morning out to you, and I would like all of you to respond back with top of the morning. So, top of the morning.
Top of the morning.
That was a bit like with the enthusiasm of a group of Lindsay Lohans after a night in the town. So let's try it one more time. Top of the morning. Yay, rock and roll. Okay, thank you, and welcome to the presentation. And whether it is top of the morning or whether it is was up, what I would like to do is wish each and every one of you 100,000 greetings and welcomes to what I hope will be a fabulous Harley-Davidson Rider's Edge conference here in Memphis. If you have a clear and compelling vision, it is going to help you. The Harley-Davidson mission statement for the Rider's Edge conference, I actually like it a lot. It says, "We fulfill dreams by providing a supportive, positive environment to develop basic riding skills from through highly qualified instruction, education, and coaching." That's a pretty clear goal and a pretty clear vision. He was once asked, "Mr. Hitchcock, why do you not go and see your films in the theaters? Do you not want to hear the audience scream?" And Hitchcock's response was, "My dear, when I'm filming the movie, I can hear the audience scream." And I thought that was another excellent example of the clear and compelling vision.
Do you remember when Avis would say, "We're number two, we try harder"? Well, now Avis from number one are even farther, because top of the pile, to everyone's surprise, it isn't Hertz, it's Enterprise. Do you remember when Dell could do no wrong and HP shares were going for a song, when McDonald's could do nothing right and Airbus was beating Boeing out of sight? All those scenarios were happening 3-4 years ago. Since then, they've all flipped dramatically. The business world keeps changing.